Hello everyone, welcome back. We're going to make a 3D logo using some of the new nodes that came in 18.6. Some of the S nodes and the extrude. This is just a transparent picture of Resolve's logo. It's 5 seconds long and I'm on a 30 frame per second frame rate. And now we'll go down to Fusion. Click away right about here. Hit shift spacebar. And type in S polygon. While it's selected, hit shift spacebar. And type in extrude. And then add a merge, camera, and render. Drag your media in to viewer one. With the S polygon node selected, we have to go up here and mask this out. Take note that this picture size is only 600 by 600. You don't want to get too big of a picture for this. And now we'll mask it out. If you don't already know, if you hold the control button down, you have more control of these handles. Okay, that looks good. Drag your merge node into viewer one. Now we'll move the camera and the lights and everything back. Drag your render into viewer two. Select your camera node in the inspector under transform, translation, Z-axis. And you can see in the left viewer, the first one, the camera moving back. In the viewer two, you'll see the subject start to appear. Just take it back as until you're happy with the size, you are in viewer two. Let's select the merge again. Shift spacebar, we'll add a couple lights to this and type in directional. Directional lights are a good light for this. And let's go ahead and get two of them. One is going to go in the front, and one will be in the back. The reason why I recommend two is because when you animate this, you're actually making the camera go around the logo, not the logo rotating. So if there's only one light, the backside will be dark when the camera rotates around. So select one of the lights, the front one. Go in the inspector under transform, translation, Z-axis again. Select use target. And that reminds me, we have to do that with the camera as well. It's a huge must for the camera. You can also move these around in the Viewer 1 with these little handles. I find them very intuitive, a little easier than using the controls. Let's name these as we go. We're going to call that one directional front. And then select the other one in the inspector under transform. Same thing, translation, Z-axis. Now we want to move it the other way to the back. And then hit use target. Be sure to select that. I do not have a middle mouse wheel like you guys do for moving around the 3D world with my controller. It's a handicap controller. So me pulling down this drop-down menu and doing all the things I do to make it move around is probably completely different than you guys, but that is the reason why I'm doing it that way. Just want to put them across each other, kind of like what I have in the Viewer 1 for the moment. And we'll go back to each one and turn the intensity down to halfway, somewhere around halfway, 0.5, 0.6. Okay, now let's go to the extrude. Okay, now I'm ready to go there. Hit extrude. In the inspector, you'll see you have all the controls you would normally have for 3D text. Excursion, subdivisions, bevel depth, bevel width. I'm going to set my excursion depth right in the middle at 0.1. I kind of recommend you might want to do the same for the tutorial so your figures all match mine when I line the pictures up on front and back. Make it a lot easier. And for this bevel, width and depth, I like 0.0063. But you can set yours however you'd like. Now you'll see we have some girth to our screwed. Let's select the render node. In the inspector, enable lighting and shadows. Let's add a transform right down from the camera node. So select it and then shift spacebar. And type in transform. That is the node we will animate this with. Okay, now we can cut the line from the media in to media out. Connect your render to media out. bring down your picture. We didn't really have to bring that picture down. It was already there that in that node. Click away right about here. And select the image plane. And then hit shift spacebar. Type in duplicate. Tie that into your merge. You don't have to do this if you don't want to, but I put a transform here. It makes it easier to line these two up on the face and the back. You can do it using the extrude, moving the whole object, but I found that to be very difficult compared to doing it this way. Then select the duplicate node. In the inspector, we want to have two copies, and by default, it does have two. We're going to use the translation Z offset for the front and the transform for the back one. So we'll line it up so we can see both sides of it. Probably a little more of the back. And select transform. Okay, it's translation Z value. We're going to move that to where it just touches the back of that extrude. If you don't know already, if you hold down the Alt key and use the numerals to adjust everything, you can. It's much more fine-tuned. That looks pretty good for the back. Now back to the duplicate node. Under translation, Z offset. Again, we'll hold down the Alt button. This way it doesn't affect the back one at the same time you're adjusting the front one by using that transform. If you do it the other way, you got to do them both kind of at the same time. Okay, so I ended up on a duplicate. The Z offset at 0.12 and the transform under translation, the Z offset or the Z axis at minus 0.01. Here it should be the same. Okay, now we're going to go ahead and animate this. So select the transform downstream from the camera. Make sure you're at frame 0. In the inspector under rotation, Y axis, set a keyframe. Take your playhead to the end of the 5 second at frame 149. I'm going to rotate mine 1.5 times in that 5 seconds. Seems to be about right for me. this edge is actually not black. It's still white. It looks black because of the shadows, but you can change the color of them. Go to Extrude node in the Inspector under Materials. Right here where it says Override Diffuse Color. You can check that. And then you have color options. Let's add an ambient light to this too. So select the merge again. Shift spacebar. And type in ambient. There we go. Got a little more light on the scene now. Now we're going to make this so you can stretch the timeline out as long as you want. By using a spline. We'll get to that in a moment. We're almost there. Okay, open your spline. If you have this in your way of your spline, up in the top right corner, there's a window. Select that, and it'll open it up. We only have to select Transform 3D 1. Then go over here to Zoom to Fit. Then you want to select all. You can use this button, or you can highlight them all like normal and select them that way. And the next button to the left, set relative, select that. And go ahead and close your spline. Turn that render cache on. Well, there you go. Thanks for watching, and I will see you on the next one.